And now it's time for In the Kitchen with Frank and Patty. Come on in.
Here we go.
Oh, yes. Go ahead, Frank. Thank you.
Just stall.
Thank you.
Just stall.
Oh, too much. Too much.
Just
Thank
stall.
You. Well, it's a pleasure to be with you all once again for the fourth installment of In the Kitchen with Frank and Patty. Now, I believe we have a great treat this evening. And what we're going to do is a little seasonal inspired, if you will. We're going to go with an Irish coffee cake. Coffee scones, excuse me. And wait until you see Patricia's little getup with her great inspired seasonal blazer, if you will. So we're going to go... Oh!
Hello!
There she is!
Hello,
Patricia!
Frank.
Thank you for joining us!
Thank you. I'm a few
gracing
seconds.
Gracing us with your presence.
Grace, you're welcome.
Yes, yes.
Should we do our little introduction?
Always has to make an entrance.
Of course. So this is the new and improved Live with Frank and Patty. As you can see, we have a new name, In the Kitchen with Frank and Patty. It's totally different than what it was before.
Indeed it is.
Yes.
New and improved.
And I'm Patricia.
And I'm Frank.
Should we get to cooking?
We should.
Okay.
Let's not keep them waiting.
Well, you were doing so great by yourself. I'm starting to wonder if I should be here.
Oh, I've always wondered that. But let's not worry. Let's continue.
Okay.
Should we? Yeah.
Happy St. Patrick's Day Eve, everyone.
Top of the Irish show. Happy St. Patty's Day, even though we're a day early, but you know,
yes.
Thursdays is our thing.
Well, in honor of St. Patrick's Day, we are going to be making, as you said, Irish
yes.
coffee cake scones.
Scones.
And even though we are professionals, we've never made scones.
Never.
So this will be an experience for all of us.
It's a journey for everyone involved.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah.
You know what I just realized?
What's up?
I need to be over there.
Oh, that's right. We have spots.
This is my good side.
Spots, spots, spots.
See, notice?
Indeed, I see it.
Yes.
Yes.
All right, well, shall we get started?
Side. Let's dive on in.
I'm so excited.
Dive on in.
Okay, so what we have here today is some flour, some sugar, some brown sugar, some cultured low-fat buttermilk. Gotta splurge for that low-fat. We have some raisins, which this recipe called for currants, man.
Oh.
Well, we didn't have any currants, so we're using raisins. We got some milk.
Raisins are great.
Yes, they are. Some Crisco, or shortening.
Crisco.
Chopped walnuts, some butter, and some other good stuff that we'll get to.
You get the drift.
Right. Oh, and here's the eggs. Okay. Should we get started?
Let's do it.
Okay.
So there are two steps in this process, am
okay.
I correct?
Yes, I
right.
believe so, yes.
So one for the scones, and then one for the topping.
The topping.
Which is the coffee cake topping.
It's a crumbly coffee cake dropping.
Mm.
I mean topping.
What? Oh my goodness. A topping.
Not
folks,
a dropping,
the
folks.
The tea.
I need to pull it, Mom.
It is, yes. Pull it together.
Sorry,
while
sorry.
You're at it.
Okay.
So what do you think? The topping first?
Let's make the topping first.
All right, let's do the topping.
Okay,
what,
so we should use a small bowl,
we
right?
shall, yes.
Okay.
We're going to use this measuring device, correct?
All right.
Don't
yes.
you make?
This device, yes.
Device?
That's a good idea.
Okay, so it says a third cup of shortening.
Okay, ooh. This stuff can get messy, right?
Indeed. We're probably going to need...
Oh.
Some sort of utensil to get that out of there.
It looks like
Don't you think?
Whipped topping.
It's solid, though.
Ugh.
It doesn't
it
smell
smells
good.
Great.
It doesn't smell good. It's not
isn't,
supposed to.
Isn't this the stuff that you can light on fire like a candle? Margie?
I don't know.
Can't you light this stuff on fire like
if
a candle?
Put a wick in it.
Put a wick in
oh.
it, light on fire, and it burns for hours just in case the power goes out. Okay, should we scoop it?
Yeah.
It has such a weird
yep, third
texture.
Cup. That's the
I should
third
probably
cup line,
be,
right?
I'll use a knife. I need a kniffy. Margie, do we have any live viewers?
Yeah, that's
Not
right.
Not yet. No live viewers, Frank.
Just give it a minute.
Okay.
Patience, patience.
Patience.
Little Brooke.
Oh, you knew where I was going.
Not gonna sing.
Oh, Chloe Fox just
Hello,
hey,
Chloe!
I miss you. Hope you're doing good.
We both miss you. Hope this just
keep it coming.
It looks like icing.
I wouldn't eat it like icing.
Oh. that's what I think about that. Okay. Is
yeah,
that good?
Tell me how you really feel.
No, you need more.
Okay.
I see a push it down.
Push it down.
Yeah,
I'm
feel
just
all
gonna,
this
I'm
out,
gonna
right?
sing a lot today.
You feeling the
I am feeling
the music,
I'm
you
feeling
the vibes.
I'm feeling
in your soul.
My heritage. I just might have to whip out
which
my
is
accent.
What?
Irish.
Oh. You
I
are
mean,
Irish?
I am indeed.
Are
aren't
you?
You?
I am indeed.
I couldn't tell.
Top of the coil.
The coil. It does really sound.
Have a kiss from me bye.
Have a kiss from me bye.
Okay.
Oh,
so,
we better be pushing the shortening and
bowl. Do this nice and slow, as we learned from last week.
What?
Don't punch it.
Punch it.
Thank you, dear. Okay, and we're going to do a third cup of chopped walnuts.
Ooh.
Got the walnuts here, already pre-chopped.
Pre-chopped, but I don't know, they kind of look still pretty big for a topping. I think we should chop them more.
Okay.
Sometimes pre-chopped just isn't chopped enough.
And that's
like
the third cup
walnut.
Line, right? It's not that dotted one.
Yes, it's the dotted one. The number is in the middle. Yeah, you're good. Just a little bit more? Oh, it's okay.
Okay. Well, I just love this jacket.
Thank you.
It's very green.
This is my St. Patrick's Day jacket. And there used to be shoulder pads, so I would look like Dorothy from Golden Girls, but I took them out.
Oh!
I don't want to look
or,
like a man.
Anyone from the movie Working Girl, I feel like.
Yes.
A lot of shoulder pads in that movie.
Sigourney.
Sigourney.
Would you like to chop my nuts?
Excuse me?
I mean, with the chopper.
That's inappropriate.
Now, this is a very special chopper we have had for years from Pampered Chef. And it's wonderful.
You can chop
and it's so
anything.
Fun. Watch this. Okay, go ahead, Frank. Keep going.
I chop it too fine.
Ding,
oh,
ding,
okay.
Ding, ding,
ding, ding. Okay, so should
don't
we...
Don't chop it too fine.
Should we pour them in?
We should.
We should? Wait,
yep.
wait. Let's... Oh, okay. Yeah.
Right?
And... Oh, wait.
Add all ingredients into one of the snitters if our mushroom is fully incorporated.
Perfectly chopped. You are the perfect nut chopper. Oh, my goodness.
Thank you. Yes.
Goodness.
Francis is...
Francis is popping out. I mean... You're working out.
Keep a G, Patty.
Sorry, Frank.
Okay. So, 3/8 cup. How in the world are you supposed to say that?
3/8
cup brown sugar.
Oh, wait, what's
or
that?
Or a fourth cup.
Okay. 3/8
plus 2 tablespoons.
Well, it says we can do 1/4 a cup and 2 tablespoons of brown sugar. Sugar. Oh, there was already a knife and I didn't see it.
No worries.
Seals.
That's not
they're
in the drawer. That's
Margie.
A salad chopper.
A salad chopper. Mm-hmm. Wow. Look at that, Frank.
That looks like a murder weapon.
It does. It looks like you could just like get something and just...
Yeah. Or it looks like a garden tool. Is that what it's for?
Yeah,
it's
like
a salad
a...
chopper.
Oh,
put
it's
all
for
your stuff
salad.
In. Salad.
Oh,
in
that's
bowl.
Nifty. That's nifty. Where'd you get it from? Pampered Chef?
Pampered Chef.
Boom.
We love the Pampered Chef.
Make it like a little slit in this thing, right?
A sliver? Yes.
A sliver. I said a slit.
A slit.
You just
on
make a slit.
On one bar soap and slit.
What'd you call me?
Nothing.
Why is this so difficult?
You need assistance.
I need a slit.
Oh my.
Oh goodness.
Chelsea's joining us now.
Hello, Chelsea!
Chelsea!
I or EA?
I or EA?
Oh, Chelsea Lee.
Oh,
Chelsea! Hey! Alrighty.
Okay.
Thanks for joining. We wish you were here.
We
fourth
wish...
cup?
Okay. Fourth the cup.
Yep.
This makes me nervous.
Slow and steady. Nice and easy. You're doing great.
Thanks, Frank. You're such a good helper.
Yeah, anything to help you out there.
Yeah. I want to try to do my Irish accent again. I'm just saying that so I'll remember.
We're just waiting for it.
I gotta think of something to say.
Okay.
The luck of the Irish, be to ya.
Oh, not bad, not bad.
No. Speaking of the Irish.
Yes.
Stay tuned, live viewers, because when we come back from the break and reveal our lovely scones, we're going to be giving away an Irish prize.
Oh my goodness.
And unfortunately, it is not an Irish man.
Oh goodness.
It's just a prize.
All right, just top it off.
Just a little bit.
A little bit.
How am I still doing
this? You're good,
this? I feel like I've been doing
That's
this
all
for
I wanted.
Oh, you're moving a lot. Okay.
Now you have to pack it.
I thought you meant back in the bag.
Pull it together,
Patty. I knew what she meant, Frank.
So, a fourth cup plus two tablespoons. Could you get out the tablespoon?
Yes.
They might still be in the drawer.
Right on it.
What's everyone's plans for St. Patrick's Day?
Oh, look at these scissors.
They're in the drawer.
The other drawer.
Which one?
Oh, behind me.
I'll take care of it.
I found them.
Gotta keep that smile on.
Okay.
Smiley face. Oh, she's got them. Great. There we go.
Wait, these are all teaspoons.
So, what's everyone's favorite dessert to make? That's a fair question to ask, right? What's everyone's go-to?
How many tisps are in a tubule? Three. Okay.
Three teaspoons are in a tablespoon?
What were you asking, Frank?
So we need six then?
Yes.
Okay. So
what were you asking the audience?
What's everyone's favorite dessert to make?
Oh,
their go-to?
That's a great question.
Right?
Has anyone commented?
Well, I just asked it.
She's
a little pushy today, folks.
Chelsea says slow and steady, nice and easy.
She knows.
Chitch.
She knows how to cook.
One.
I know. I'm going as fast as I can. Two.
It might be St. Patrick's Day before you get these done.
Oh! How many was that?
Three, four.
That's a lot of brown sugar.
Five.
Oh, Chelsea says brownies are cookies because they are the easiest to make, and I am always hungry for them.
Amen.
Amen. Keep it simple.
Okay.
2 tablespoons of white sugar. So, 6 more of those.
6 more of these. Frank, why don't you finish up the crumble and I'll start on the dough?
Sure.
Just to keep things moving along here. Okay. Milk, raisins, chopped scissors. Okay.
Oh, and she says in your no-bake cookies, yum.
Oh,
my goodness. Oh. No-bake cookies are my favorite, not only to eat, but to make. And Chelsea, our good old friend, and friend still.
Good old friend.
Who says that?
So there's three and one?
Two and one.
Why?
So there's six.
Three teaspoons
and one tablespoon.
So there's six.
Mm-hmm. There's three and one?
There's
did
three.
I do enough last time?
Yeah, we did six.
Okay.
We call for two.
So six.
Okay.
But yes, Chelsea has many a times had our no-bake cookies. My no-bake cookies. We'll have to make those sometime.
Mm-hmm.
They're so good. And you don't have to bake them, as the name clearly states. Okay, I should start now. We need to preheat the oven to 425. Preheating. And we want to whisk together 1 egg and 2 tablespoons of... Wait a minute, I need to set that aside. Am I reading out loud again?
No, it's just funny.
You need to find the tablespoon.
She
I know.
Mars,
Tell me about it.
Help us out here.
I'll find it.
Wait, wait, what's this? Is this a tablespoon?
What's that say?
It says Lexan. No, I wasn't reading it upside down.
Give it that.
Does it have a measurement on it?
No.
There's no way. That is huge.
Maybe it's for something to do with the car. I need a measuring board. This will do. All right, so the recipe says to whisk together 1 egg and 2 tablespoons. We need a lot of tablespoons.
I know we used tablespoons last time.
Of milk to wash and set aside. Oh, so we're making the egg wash that we're going to put over top right before we bake it. So I'm going to make
it in a cup.
In a cup?
Do it in a cup.
Okay, in a cup.
Here.
Oh, lovely.
And I'm going to look for your tablespoon.
Okay.
You move over
Thanks,
there.
Thanks, Marge.
I'll look for your tablespoon.
How's it going, Frank?
Just fine.
I'm using my personal favorite Christmas gift I've ever given that says Griswold Family Christmas. I gave this to Papa. And he loves it. A little splashy there now, Frank. You're doing so good, though. You're not going to ever have too many cooks in the kitchen. All right, I'm going to whisk together 1 egg and 2 tablespoons of milk.
Somebody stole the tablespoon off of here.
It was Papa.
He doesn't cook.
Where do all the tablespoons go? Frank?
Yes, sir.
Frank, did you use the tablespoon?
Just use the tablespoon.
We'll just make do.
God bless Marjorie.
Indeed. Where's the... Okay. Now, remember how I told everyone to crack an egg? You tap twice on the counter, twice on your friend, twice on the bowl.
Oh, hi, Barb.
Hello, Barb. Welcome.
Hi, Barb.
I don't know. Stop.
She's my friend, Barb.
Sorry.
It's okay. I don't know who that is.
Don't tell me what to do. Sorry. I mean, hi.
Frank!
What?
What's that?
Is that not a tablespoon or is that a teaspoon?
That's tisp.
Tisp.
Isn't tisp of a tablespoon? I cannot believe we are out of tablespoons. What kind of cooks are we?
I tell me about it. I don't know what we did last week.
I know we used a tablespoon.
Where is that? 1 egg teaspoon. An egg.
Right here.
Thank you, dear.
You're welcome.
Oh.
Good job.
All right, topping is... This is the salt we're doing?
Yes. Ooh, I need to pour me some milk. Oh, I'm so thirsty I could drink some of this milk right now.
Well, have at it.
What if I just took this and just...
What's stopping you?
You know what? Nothing is. I should take a drink.
You should.
After
Not
I...
from the cart.
Okay.
Tis, Patrish.
I'll make the egg wash first. By the way, Frankie.
By the by.
You know what I realized the other day?
What did you realize, Patricia?
If you switched the first letters of both of our names, we would be Prank and Fatty. Just thought I'd point that out. I'm Fatty, you're Prank.
Oh my gosh, no way.
I just realized that.
That is something else.
I know, right?
Oh my gosh.
Two tablespoons. That's hilarious. I'm going to steal your tisp.
So, the topping is finished. All ingredients into a bowl mixed together using a fork until shortening is fully incorporated. I need a fork. Is the utensils where you're standing?
Yes.
Oh, take your time, please.
Thank you.
Isn't she just a treat?
I lost track of how many I was pouring.
Oh,
you did too.
I'm sorry.
Thank you, Marge. Isn't she great, folks? Give her a hand at home.
Please do. What would we do without her?
3. How many do I need?
Barb says the cutest thing she ever saw.
What? Us?
I guess, yeah.
Thanks, Barb. She's probably talking about my green jacket.
The jacket.
us go, Frank. We are just too good.
What does it mean by until shortening is fully incorporated?
I think
you want
fully
it to be
mixed.
Crumbly. You want it to be crumbly.
Sure,
you don't
want
to mix it. You want to crumble it.
Crumble it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Wait, so am I doing it right?
So, kind of like this.
What does that mean? This is what she did. I don't know what that means.
You kind of chop it.
Kind
of. And keep it in the bowl.
Let that break. You got to put some elbow into it.
You
got
to look like
blue shit,
Ethel, I hate to say.
I'll take that.
I'm Lucy.
Please.
You're the sidekick. Oh, I forgot your red hair. Fine.
Exactly.
You're Lucy. But I'm
not
going to cry.
I'm not
going
to cry. Just like
Lucy.
Lucy.
I can't do
it. Lucy.
Such a good show.
Oh, love it. Love, love, love
well,
it.
I think I whisked the topping together enough. I should have used a smaller whisk. But hey, gotta make do.
Gotta do with what you got.
Look at that crumbly goodness. Oh my goodness, Frank, you are just too good.
It's just gonna crumble when you eat it.
Crumble.
You'll crumble with desire.
Frank.
Oh.
I'm trembling for crumble.
That's what I was looking for, something like that, yeah. You got what I was putting down.
I did. I know you. Wait.
She's
okay,
so
wait.
Smooth, really one with the words over here.
I'm like a poet and I don't know it.
Oh my gosh.
I think that's done.
She's such a ham.
She doesn't take it.
We're not.
Not at all, Marge. Please.
Marge. What was the motion she was doing again?
That. She was like, chop it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, excuse me.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. What's next?
I think I got my crumble going.
Oh, it looks wonderful. Show that to the audience,
you
Frank.
You like that crumble?
And that's how the crumble crumbles.
And that's how the topping crumbles.
That looks delicious. Here, let's set it over here.
Very good.
Thank you.
Put that right next to my egg topper.
Oh, did you make the topping?
I did.
Nice.
I made us our egg wash.
Nice. Let's move on to the next,
all
shall
right.
we?
Now we're going to use a fork. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah. Oh, okay. Wait, I skipped. Oh.
So should I be
medium
filling while you're
wait.
Reading?
We need another bowl. Oh, I shouldn't have. Oh, I need another bowl.
Why do you need another bowl?
It says we have to mix the wet separate and then mix the dry. Oh, here come the bowls. Thank you, Marge. You are a peach.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. Now that we have our bowl, you can mix the wet and I'll mix the dry.
Okay.
Or vice versa.
Sounds good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wet, dry.
Wet?
Wet.
I'll dry. Be wet. Sure.
It's been a long day.
Oh my goodness.
I needed to giggle.
And indeed you did.
I did.
What?
Okay.
So much for keeping this G-rated.
I didn't say it. I'm just laughing. So you're the wet, and I'm the dry. Okay. So you're doing the eggs, extract, buttermilk.
Yes.
So I'll hand you your buttermilk and your eggs, and I'll take all this dry stuff.
So this is what I'm doing.
You're doing number...
Three.
I'm doing two. Okay. Oh, and by the way, everyone...
Andy wants to know what you're making.
I was just about to say that. It's like I read your mind, Andrew. And welcome, by the way.
Hey, Drew.
We are making Irish coffee cake scones in honor of St. Patrick's Day. Isn't that festive? They're going to be delicious.
Indeed.
They're going to have some raisins and some sugar. You know, all the things you need to have a healthy, well-lived life. And we're going to have tea with it. Just saying, because what's a scone without some tea? All right. Oh, and by the way, everyone, you can find a copy of this recipe after the show on ChristiBalisti.com/FrankandPatty.
Yes.
All right. And Frank is mixing the wet, and I'm mixing the dry ingredients.
Indeed.
How are you doing, Frank?
Just fine. I need a table, a teaspoon. You have a teaspoon over there?
Did I take your teaspoon?
Well,
there's a set for you.
You don't need one?
We'll see. Okay, so I need 2.5 cups of flour. I'll use this after I clean it off. I must say, Frank, this might be the most involved recipe we've ever done.
I think it might be the most complex. Where's the almond extract?
I thought it was over there.
I thought you said you wanted to use the vanilla instead.
Oh, we're using vanilla. We are substituting vanilla for almond extract.
Okay.
Because vanilla's good.
Indeed.
The vanilla's good. I need to get back my Irish accent.
You'll get it. That stuff takes time.
It does, indeed. But once I start, I'm not going to
be able
to stop. You
gotta work at it. Yeah, right?
So,
be prepared. Be prepared.
That was lovely.
Thank you.
We are just using a lot of spoons here. Okay, so I'm just going to pour that right in there. Now make sure to crack the egg like I showed you, Frank. Very nice. You didn't crack it on your friends.
Oh, I was like, what is she talking about? A little doo-doo, a little dee-dee, a boo-boo.
Stick it in my mouth.
Keep it a little silly here. A
little bit. You gotta keep it silly in the kitchen.
Oops.
Oh, he's a pro, folks. I tell you what.
Learn from the best.
Mm-hmm.
La Francie, Francie. I learned in Paris.
Did you learn in the Paris?
I did, indeed.
Oui. Frank, are you doing okay over there?
Yes, I'm fine.
Good, good.
No gasping.
What? Did I do that?
Then
I knew you were going to
I couldn't help it.
One.
Okay, eggs, and then the buttermilk.
I've never smelled buttermilk. Let's sniff it together.
You can sniff it, you'll say.
We're going to sniff it together. The oven is preheated. We better hurry up. Are you gonna sniff it with me? Oh! Wait. Give me another whiff. Oh! It's good and yet it's bad. But it's gonna make it delicious.
It's sour milk.
Oh, is it really? Interesting.
Why is it called buttermilk and not sour milk?
Would you buy it if it said sour milk?
I would not.
No, I would not either.
I expected it to smell like butter milk.
Did you really?
You can make your own buttermilk by adding a little vinegar to your milk.
Vinegar and milk.
It will make it sour.
Oh my.
You told us that when we
hate vinegar. Vinegar to me is the worst thing in the world. Okay, maybe not
vinegar?
The worst thing. Yeah, I hate vinegar.
Interesting.
I like vinegar. Would you just drink it? Drink it?
No. Does anyone do that?
Apple cider vinegar.
Apple cider vinegar.
Helps you lose weight.
I do that.
Not worth it.
With a little bit of honey?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, Frank.
Haven't you ever heard that?
I guess I maybe have. Flour.
I need a half cup. Do you have a half cup over there that I can use?
Yes,
I do. The buttermilk.
Andrew says, will you save him one of
these?
No,
yeah. Andrew. I mean, yes, Andrew, sure.
Of course.
Get the card. Come on over.
He already got... Okay, actually, here's a little spoiler.
Do you not have a half cup?
I have a third cup. Here, you can use this.
Okay.
Here, you can use that. Last week, our dear friend Andrew was lucky enough to win our drawing. Or sorry, not drawing. Our contest to win the prize. The prize was that he got 2 slices of cherry cheese coffee cake and the prize. Well, somebody in the house ate all the cherry coffee cake. It was not me.
It was not me.
It wasn't Marge, because she's not eating sugar. And it was, okay, it was me.
Well, then who was it?
I shared it with Frank. I mean, you're Frank. I shared it with Grandma.
I sure had some.
I shared it with Grandma.
It was so good. It was so good.
So, Andrew, yes, you can have some scones to make up for the prize you did not get. Sorry again.
So he never
got any of the prize.
Poor guy.
Oh, he's fine. Oh, now I need the half cup. Oh, here, I'll just use 2.
He went.
4 cups.
Oh, duh.
Promising you make him another coffee cake, I think.
And I will keep that promise. I will. Okay, I finally am done with the flour. Smack it. Go ahead, Frank. I'm watching. Oh! Bravo. That was excellent.
Thank you.
And I'm not even... silly.
Thank you. Good form, huh?
Your eggs are showing.
Oh my. How embarrassing.
Yes. It's all right. We'll
mind your own business. My eggs will be open if they want to.
I will just mind my dry.
Yeah, you do your dry and I'll do it. I never.
Well, I've never been so insulted.
My next question.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Oh, wait, I think you whisk it. You whisk it. Whisk together. Whisk it. Yeah, whisk that.
So, this step here was supposed to be from these measurements here, correct?
Yes.
I was just making sure.
I'm just saying yes.
See what I get?
There was egg on that.
There is nothing on this.
I used that to whisk my egg.
There is a little something on this. I'm sorry.
It's all right. I've tasted egg before.
Karma is sure as whipped.
I do declare I have never had egg on my face. Until now. Okay, I need to put some sugars. 1/4 of a cup of... Now, Marge, I have a question for you, Marge. What's the difference between light sugar and dark sugar? Do you know?
One's lighter and one's darker.
Thank you, Marge. Words of wisdom.
And if you ever want to make your own brown sugar, you can take white sugar and add molasses to it.
Molasses? That's what makes it brown?
Yeah.
Interesting. Marge, you really are a bevy of knowledge.
Truly. And good word.
Thank you.
So if you want dark brown sugar, add more molasses.
That is... Well, and I tried to get dark brown, but they only had light brown. Yes.
Where is that?
You're doing great, Frank. It says, in a medium bowl, whisk other 2 eggs, almond extract, and vanilla milk.
Oh, it did say that.
Don't look at that top one, because I think that top one will is confusing you. Sometimes you just gotta improvise, folks. Pack it. Okay. Now, real sugar, I need, another 4th of a cup. Let's put it in. I love sugar. Are you almost done with your wet?
I'm done with my wet.
Okay, I'm almost done with my dry.
Okay.
Baking powder. Baking powder, please. Right there. Right there.
The what?
That.
This?
Yes. Thank you.
Sorry about that.
It's all right, Frank. I did not enunciate properly.
Well, I was a little confused.
It's all right. Teaspoon? Oh, no, I don't want this. I just cannot believe we lost our tablespoon. Because this recipe has all tablespoons. Oh, that's all right. I need...
Yeah, it was like
one tablespoon, so 3 teaspoons. 1, 2, and 3. I have a kiss from me, bye.
There
it's
it is.
It's almost coming back. Almost. I'll get there.
I have a kiss from me, bye.
I have a kiss from me, bye. I'm just going to whisk this together. Okay.
It's hard. It's a tough one.
Salt. Oh, goodness, I'm not done yet. Salt. 1/2 teaspoon. We are using Himalayan salt.
Ooh,
correct,
yeah.
Mark?
It's the best for you.
It is
it's the best for you.
All right, salt and nutmeg. Which, should we do the nutmeg?
Yes.
And we should.
Okay, how much nutmeg do I need? Oh, I crossed it out.
Nice.
1 teaspoon! Finally, I need a teaspoon. Now, where is it? Okay. What if it just, like, went all the way up my nose? That's a lot of nutmeg.
Now you want to level it off. You don't want... You just want 1 teaspoon.
All right! We're done with the dry.
Yay! Oh, you...
Have you seen that one Woody Allen movie? Annie Hall.
You'll have to be more specific.
Annie Hall. Whenever they have all of the, you know, and the guy's like, how much is it per pound? And then he sneezes and it goes all over.
Yeah.
It gets me
every
time.
What a great movie. What a great movie.
Oh, Woody.
Classic.
Oh, I'm making a mess. Okay.
Oh, you're fine.
I think we are ready
to make some
merge.
Perfect.
What?
Nothing. Let's merge.
All right, we're about to merge.
Merge.
I think we're ready to merge.
Okay, let's do it.
Incorporate the butter into... Okay, using a fork or pastry cutter. Do we have a pastry cutter?
Fork will do.
Fork. Oh, fork.
Oh, fork.
Okay. Incorporate
the
butter.
What's going on? Talk to me.
But we're going to incorporate, merge this and that until medium-sized crumbs appear. So slowly.
Okay.
Because we have to have medium-sized crumbs.
Okay.
So let's take out
one. Do you put the butter in then?
Oh, yeah. Where is the butter? I don't see... Butter.
Uno momento.
I don't see butter. But it's on the recipe. Help, Marge, help. Help, Marge. Do we have any live viewers left?
I think Andrew's still there.
Hello, Andrew.
Oh, my goodness.
I guess I should have looked this up before you started.
Don't see butter.
Stay in the shot.
Okay. Hidey, hidey, ho, hide, hide, ho. I guess I should sing some Celtic thunder.
Hidey, 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 ho. From the Blues Brothers. When he's sullen. Before they come to the concert at the end. No?
No. I'll just dance.
Oh my gosh.
I'm a single ex. I'm a single ex. I'm a single ex.
What's this half cup of cold butter cubed? So, I would think that's in... Oh, right here. Using the fork or pastry cutter, incorporate the butter into the flour mixture.
Until
medium-sized crumbs.
Oh, I thought
then you
meant
stir
that.
In, then you stir in the
so
raisins.
The
do not over-mix.
Okay, so...
Then
so.
You add the wet ingredients.
Okay.
We put this in by the cube...
It's supposed to be cubed.
Okay, so we need a sharp knife.
Using a fork or a pastry cutter, incorporate the butter into the flour mixture. Until medium-sized crumbs appear. Stir in the currants. Do not overmix.
I just did not see
here,
that.
You can cube it on this plate.
Okay. Thank you, dear. So a half a cup, it says. Half a cup cold butter cubed.
Now that's a full stick, correct?
Is right? it?
Oh, Barb's still there. Hi, Barb.
Hi, Barb.
I'm so glad you're still here. Okay.
Is that right, Sandy?
Full butter stick is half a cup.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously?
Yes, indeed, my dear friend. Okay, so we stir this into that until cubes form.
Did she do it too?
She did indeed. What you doing there, Frank?
Would you like me to show you how to do it?
No, well, we got this. We're the professionals, right?
Hey, Angel!
Hi, Angel. Our studio cat just walked in.
She's our mascot.
Look what the cat walked in. don't mess with the tripod. No, Angel. Go. Shoo-shoo. Go
she
sleep.
It down. She just wants to be a part of it.
No, don't do it. Don't.
Oh, that's just
cubed.
Okay.
Is that cubed enough?
Once you start.
All right, let's do it. Mix it.
Do you want a fork?
We mix.
You chop, like I told you.
Chop.
Is that what you're doing?
I guess. This is a little tough.
You can also use knives to make the butter and the flour mixture. Use a chopping crisscross motion. You can use knives too.
Who said that?
Barb.
Thank you, Barb.
Ooh.
Look, she must be
All right,
a professional
knives.
Too.
Crisscross motion.
Okay, knives.
Mary McCoy's here.
Hey, Mary!
Hey, Mary.
So, like this?
Yeah.
Crisscross?
Yes.
Gosh!
Wouldn't it be cool if you need
those kinds
knives.
Of knives, like butter knives.
But I do.
You
do
need
I really?
Butter knives.
Dang it.
She's so violent, folks.
I want to be for Vendetta.
She wants to be,
Okay, well, here's yours. We can pretend like we're Wolverine. Oh. Too soon. Okay.
Don't give any spoilers away.
Okay, let's take out the forks.
Crisscross applesauce. How's that go?
En garde. Hello. My name is Indigo Baker.
Ah.
You killed my souffle. Prepare to die.
Barb says, watch out, Frank.
Right? It's dangerous up in here,
chop
Barb.
Chop it, Frank. Chop it. We're making a good team. Well, look at it go.
Chop it, Daddy. Chop it. Gosh.
It's looking good, Marge.
It's looking lumpy.
The butter is basically gone.
Is that what we want?
Yeah, right.
You want crumbs.
You want crumbs. So I'm going to just go back to the fork.
Remember it said don't overmix.
Don't overmix. Okay. So we do want this. Like I said before, folks, we've never made scones before.
So this is a journey.
Definitely not Irish coffee cake scones.
No. We're ambitious folk up in these lands. Gosh, that was
that
Jamaican.
Was, it was kind of
like
Jamaican.
Oh my gosh,
but
that was awful.
There was a little bit of Scottish.
I can't mix the scones.
Oh, that was good.
I'm William Wallace.
Nice.
Thank you. Apparently,
oh,
I guess I can do
movie.
That movie's so good. Okay, so what now?
Add the raisins.
Add the currants.
How many currants? 3/4 cup.
Third cup. 3/4 cup.
Third cup. I think they're a little packed. In there.
You're a little packed.
I have a pack of abs. Under the pack of donuts.
Well, Mary says you should have a live studio audience because she wants to see you guys.
Well, Mary.
Oh, that's a good idea, Mary.
It's funny you mention that because we are considering doing
Angel.
Just that thing. Angel, we are live. She just wants to be the center of attention.
Always.
Don't know where she gets that.
Like cat, like owner.
Yeah, Marge.
I mean, okay. Sure.
Okay. How you doing there, Frank?
Fine. Ready?
I'm ready. Woo! It's a fire now!
Oh!
We need three of those.
Three of them? Oh, this is a fourth cup?
3/4 cup, yes. Hide the raisins.
I always think you're going to sing that. Hide the
Okay, it's coming back.
You've the gift of the Blarney about you.
There it is.
Was that it?
Yep.
Andrew said he agrees that we should have a live audience.
Well, that's two votes for it, so I guess we need to do it, Frankie.
Guess we do. Live from the studio audience, it's Frank and Patty!
Woo, woo, woo!
And Chloe wants to come too.
Yes!
Who does? Who
Chloe.
Does? Chloe!
So it'll be okay. That without that awkward dance move at the end.
Wait, don't we need a third one?
Yes.
That was my whale!
Your what?
I was doing the whale.
Let's see it again.
Christy, don't overmix it.
Oh, okay. Wait, what's my name, Marge?
Oh, sorry, Patty.
Thank you, Marge.
What's my name?
Say my name.
When no one is around you. Say with me, I love you if you went rolling games.
Say my name.
You acting kind of crazy. You ain't calling me baby. Why
did
the
you
sun
say
hits?
I am crazy? I am not crazy.
Patrish.
Francis.
When it comes to your man.
What?
Estoy loco.
Loca. Pardon me.
Si.
No, if I could speak Spanish, I would give it to you.
Clearly you don't.
I kind of went little mafia there.
I saw that.
I think I'm over...
With that hand? Hey! Watch out! Look out! King Cobra!
Oh, okay, we need to just refocus.
That jacket.
Is the jacket too much?
Tell me, did you recently win a golf tournament?
I'm sorry, Francis. Don't make me.
Make you.
You don't want to know. Okay, let's move on.
Don't overmix.
Not overmixing. I'm just moving it.
Alrighty.
Now we need to
add the wet ingredient.
Add the wet. Let's get the wet. Now
merge.
We need to merge. We're gonna merge now.
Commence
slowly.
Merge.
Merge, come in. Wait. Use the spout. It sizzles.
I'll show you my spout.
Frank!
Please.
Such sass. Beautifully done. Oh, wait, there's a little bit more in there, I think. I was wrong. Lovely. Isn't that fascinating?
Indeed, it is fascinating.
Do you want to help me make?
Cooking is fascinating.
Isn't it fun?
Is it
it's
done
like
with forks?
Science, but you can eat it. What? Oh.
Yes, I believe they call it home sciences. Home economics.
Interesting. Is that really what it's called?
Yes, it is.
You learn something every day. All right, help me mix, Brian.
Okay.
Now, does it matter if we mix it? Okay, just until it stays together and forms the duh.
Is that what it said?
Indeed. When no one is around you. That's stuck in my head now.
It's such a good song.
I wish I knew a good Irish folk song. Are Celtic Thunder Irish, or are they Scottish, or are they something else altogether? I know there's bagpipes.
That's a good question,
and
actually.
Hot fellas singing things.
Sorry.
It's all right. Oh, we're forming the dough now.
The dough.
I'm going to get out the spatula to get that extra stuff on the side.
Does the dairy need a little dough? Yeah. A couple bucks. She got it.
Margie
got it.
So confused.
Oh, I think it's just, yeah, a buck.
Oh, Frank.
Get it? Does the deer need a little dough?
Oh.
Yeah, buck.
You didn't say deer, did you?
Yes, I did.
Oh.
I do, Margie, would like that.
I'm glad Margie
did our audience think that was funny.
No, it was a lame joke.
I didn't get it.
I'll give you some little emojis here.
Thank you, Marge.
Say my name.
No one.
Nice try, Frank.
Oh,
you
dare
were,
you.
No, you were on a roll earlier. You could not do any better than you did before.
Well, I always can do better.
It was perfect.
Okay, don't overmix her. It'll get tough.
Well, there's lots of... Hold on.
She's right. I think we should say...
There's lots of stuff on the bottom. It's got a soggy, dry bottom.
Oh, Barb said she got your joke. It's an old one.
Oh.
It is, Barb.
Barb is so sweet. Can I just put my hands
it's
in it?
It's what my dad says.
Well, you're going to be putting your hands in, but are they clean?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm just going to put them in.
Okay.
Sometimes
you're
going to
have to separate it anyway.
Here's another
lots...
one for my dad. What does the tractor say to the plow? Pull me closer, John Deere.
Oh! I love it.
My dad is full of those.
I love it.
He is full of those.
There is
ones.
So much stuff underneath. That was a good one.
Andrew said it's very Three Stooges like.
Those jokes? Yeah, they are. They're really old. Yeah. Like I said, my dad's full of those. They're great, though.
One.
I love them. They're so simple, but they're so classic. They're so funny.
I've got a joke.
Okay.
Okay. How does Moses make his tea?
I don't know.
He brews it.
That's good. Very funny.
I can't get that,
very funny.
I can't get that underlying flour in there. Oh, now I got it. It's just in there. It's not mixing.
Yeah. You can use your hands. That's a good
it's
thing.
Being stubborn, huh?
Yeah. See, look at all that.
Oh, yeah. Get in there.
I'm in there. I'm getting it. I'm getting it good.
Get it good.
Okay. Almost there.
We are getting close to making
Barb told the joke. You want to hear it?
Yeah,
yes,
of course.
Go ahead.
Nothing runs like a deer. But nothing stinks like a John.
Runs like a deer.
I don't get it.
Stinks
a John.
Like a
oh, okay, okay, okay.
Oh, like
okay,
the
okay,
toilet.
I get it.
Like a man named John.
Oh.
That's funny.
Yeah, like John stinks. I don't know. That's just what I pictured.
That's funny.
Okay, we're almost there.
Okay. You need to clean. Okay, Frank, maybe you clean off all that.
Yes,
you're going to need that to roll out your dough.
Yes. Thank you, Marge. I'm almost there. This is going to be the fun part, everybody. Frank, you're going to love this next part.
Am I?
Yes, you are.
Well, if anybody knows me, it's you.
You're just going to smack. It's just such a cute little loop. Okay, I think it's ready. Now, what we're going to do next, we're going to shape in half. Okay, we're going to cut this in
half. You need to wipe that off and clean that off first.
Oh, yes, we have a few little spills.
What do we need to wipe it down with?
There's a paper towel.
Paper towel and just wet. Excuse me. These scones are going to be so good with our tea. If you're a tea lover, this is the scone to make. And if you're Irish, that helps too. The luck of the Irish be to you.
Oh, nice.
I almost got it. What did I say before? You've got the blarney about you. We're going to put the scones down on the counter now. Very nice, Frank.
First, you need to sprinkle some flour.
Oh, yes. I mean, oh, yes. Sprinkle the flour. Sprinkle it now. Just leave it over there. I changed into British.
Yeah, I noticed.
Okay, flour.
I'll just hold the dough.
You just gotta sprinkle some on there.
Sprinkle, sprinkle.
My hand or the bag?
Doesn't matter.
My hands are clean.
Use the wrist. Oh, he is just too good.
That's a good sprinkle.
Almost as good as his drizzle.
Drizzle, drizzle, drizzle. What do we think?
Okay,
perfect.
You can always add more if you need it.
Okay. So now, I'm going to break bread just like Jesus. We're going to pull this apart. And flap. And flap. Okay. Now we're done with this. Why, we have made quite a little mess here, Frankie.
A little bit.
Are we ready to
ready,
grumble?
Ready.
Okay.
What are we doing?
We're going to... Did you just get some powder on my face?
No.
I felt it hit.
No? You know, I thought you...
Was I not wide enough?
I thought your nose needed to be powdered, so I took the liberty.
Thank you, Frank. Always think of me.
Always a friend.
Yes,
happy to help.
Of course. Okay, so we're going to shape each of these into a circle 5 inches in diameter, 1 inch high. Tall.
One circle?
Yes. First, we're going to knead it. I need you. I need you.
How do you knead the dough?
Like this.
Like this?
Knead. Need.
Do you have to say that?
Yes.
Need. Need.
Oh, Mary says she's loving her old mama, Mrs. Peru.
Oh! That is exactly what I was thinking of, Mary.
Kiss from me, bye.
So, for a story for y'all, a short one. Me, Patty, in high school was in The Music Man, and I was Mrs. Peru. I was the librarian's mother. And it was so much fun. I think that was one of my favorite roles.
You're doing okay.
You're just gonna need. I need you. I need you. Now you
yeah,
do it,
what,
Frank.
What is that? What are you doing?
You're saying, I need you. You know, like, need a need.
Yes, I get it.
You need some more flour. I got you.
Is that what that means?
Yeah, if it sticks, you gotta have more flour. Okay, now you need to start forming your circle.
Form a circle. This is so fun.
This is fun.
Join me, Frank.
Mind just go.
Come on, Frank. Join me in my rhythm of the drum. Need.
Just remember, the more you work it, the tougher they'll be.
Oh, okay. Let's stop us. Don't look at me.
It was your idea.
Okay, sorry. I'm going to form it into a little round. Okay, so we're going to use our ruler here. Oh, yes, that's about right. No, I'm just kidding. Just going to work out the little pieces into a round circle. Wow, Frank.
How?
That's perfect. 5 inches in diameter. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, mine's a little big. I guess it doesn't really matter, does it, Marge?
No.
As long as it's near 5 inches and about an inch tall.
Mm-hmm.
How'd you make yours so round?
It's
like a perfect circle.
Now, there's a special cutter that you can use.
Oh, so cute. I just want to see.
Very cute. Looks like a big cookie.
It does.
It does.
With those currants. Currants.
Currants.
Excuse me, please. Sorry, Marge.
It's all right.
We are almost done.
This is a cutter and it goes. So you're going to cut here.
Another Pampered Chef? Nope, I was wrong.
I think it is.
Nice
progressive.
Try. It's a better enough
sell. Yes.
Oh, yeah, so do you.
Progressive International Corp. So now
International
what do we
Corp.
Do? We, okay, now we want to cut it into 6 wedges. 1. Oh, this is fun. 2. Here, you go ahead, Frank. I need to re-knead. You know what I did, Marge. Marge! Why didn't you tell me what I was doing wrong?
Oh.
Don't do what I did, Frank.
Now
don't
now
cut it this way.
Cut those in threes.
Right.
Got it.
So like
each in three.
And
oh yes.
I made a T.
Boom, boom.
I did went
gotcha.
Boom boom. Sorry, Marge. The boom boom.
Ha 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 ha
I'm sorry, are you waiting on this?
Not at all. boom, chicka licka licka boom, 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 chicka licka licka boom.
Very good. Very nice. Are you trying to distract me when I...
You mean scones or...
I meant your dancing, of course.
Good answer.
Yes.
Oh. So seriously, do you golf?
Tried it once.
I did.
I know she did. You were really into it for a minute there.
I was.
It's a nice idea at first, isn't it, until you actually try it?
I haven't actually tried it. Oh. I've only putted at the putty-putt.
It's more fun if you have a golf cart.
Oh, much more fun. It is one of the most frustrating sports you'll ever
play. You need to get your pan ready.
Pan ready. Okay. Is that what this is?
Mm-hmm.
Mine is so much more flowery than hers.
You put more flour on yours.
Does that make a difference?
No, it'll be fine.
Okay.
And I had to re-knead mine because I cut it wrong. So we're just going to... Oh, do we need to... Parchment paper. It's close. That's what it says. Or
well,
since it's a stone?
I think the stone, a seasoned stone, you should use parchment.
All right. Since this is a stone, we're not going to use parchment paper. But if you're going to use like a tin pan, you want parchment paper. These are going to be so good.
A little
it's all right. Yeah, yours is very...
Does it say to separate them?
My nose. Carefully move each scone onto baking sheet lined with brush top of scones. No, it doesn't say.
Okay.
To cut it.
Well, I think you just separate them a little because they might bake together.
Oh, okay.
And you got to put the topping and stuff on it.
Are they going to rise? Or
yeah,
expand.
They've got
baking
powder in there.
Just not as much. Okay. Okay. So now we need the egg wash. And we're going to use my favorite tool of the kitchen, the brush.